away in the Japanese countryside rests the Awaji Island. It is located in the Seto Inland Sea between Japan's largest island Honshu and Shikoku. To reach Awaji, I hopped on the Genova ferry from Akashi near Osaka, and in about 12 minutes I was dropped off in an old fishing village called Iwaya on the Awaji Island. The 12 minutes ride was absolutely magical because I was witnessing the world's largest suspension bridge connecting two islands. It is an absolute delight to watch the bridge over the vast sea. It is best to rent a car to reach Awaji via the bridge as there are no trains. But I had some different plans. I decided to explore the island on this bike. Riding along the beautiful paths lined by the stunning sea was so much fun and such a great experience. Going back in history, there is an interesting story behind the formation of this island. According to Japanese folklore, Awaji Island is the birthplace of Japan. The story goes like, gods Izanagi and Izanami stirred the sea with a spear, and when they lifted the spear from the water, a drop of brine fell from the blade and hardened on top of the ocean waves. Thus, Awaji Island was born. Soon, Izanagi and Izanami descended upon its shores to further develop the land of the rising sun. While enjoying my ride through this picturesque island, I reached the Akashi Kaikyo Park. It is a huge seaside park surrounded by green nature and colorful flowers. It includes beautiful gardens, lakes, ponds, walking trails, and Japan's biggest greenhouse. You can admire seasonal flowers throughout the year over here. Inside this park is the Awaji Yumebutai, a large complex designed by famous architect Ando Tadao, which includes a group of 100-stepped gardens which shows Japanese flower culture. It is a prayer garden built as a tribute to the victims of Great Hanshin Awaji earthquake. My next stop was at another architectural wonder, the Hompokuji Temple. It has a huge lotus pond at the entrance. However, the real surprise lays underground below the pond. Once you reach underground, it is lined by vermilion pillars and there is a sparkling Buddha temple down there. It was a fun and exciting day to explore an unknown island on a bike, and it was already time to head back home. Although I just planned a day trip to Awaji, but I just realized that's not enough. There are so many other places to see in Awaji, like the Naruto Whirlpools. Just check out the description box for more details.